And the worldwide leader in sports and the National Association for Stock Car Auto Racing welcome you live to Michigan Speedway. This is Bud Pohl qualifying for Sunday's Pepsi 400. Well, 21 events have been held so far in the 2000 Winston Cup season, and Bobby Labonte has a 101-point lead over Dale Jarrett, with five of the top 10 positions separated by 50 points or less. Here's Dr. Jerry Punch.
Bobby Labonte comes to Michigan as the Winston Cup points leader, wanting a taste of what Dale Jarrett experienced a year ago, that coveted NASCAR Winston Cup championship. After a career-tying fifth-place finish at Watkins Glen and now a comfortable season-high 101-point lead over Dale Jarrett, Bobby Labonte is moving one step closer to realizing his dream. And one would think Bobby would breathe a little easier this weekend. After all, this track has been very good to him. He won this race last August and set a new track record by catching the pole here in June. All in the same car he has here today and hopes to put on the pole. But Dale Jarrett's record's been pretty impressive here as well. He has a win and no finish worse than fifth in this race since 1996. And by the way, Michigan Speedway is where it all began for DJ 9 years ago. On this weekend in 1991, he became a first-time Winston Cup winner.
Last Sunday, Steve Park was on stage in New York. So what if it was a little off-Broadway? Okay, it was a long way from Broadway. But when it was over, Park was exactly where he wanted to be, in front of the checkered flag. He's lucky number 13, the 13th different winner this season, his first Winston Cup victory. Who's going to be the next fresh face to go to victory lane? Could it be Benson or Skinner? Maybe Michael Waltrip or Kenny Wallace, all long shots in a long race, but who would have picked Park last Sunday? Then maybe it's a former winner making that long-awaited return to victory lane, like, well, Elliott or Rod, or maybe Marlin or Ken Schrader. On Sunday, everyone is in it for the points, but some would trade them all for the win. The next star is about to take center stage at Michigan. The question is, which car is he in?
Some of the stories we'll be watching today as Bud Pohl qualifying will begin at about 13 minutes from right now at quarter of the hour. A big weekend of coverage scheduled for you here at Michigan with the NapaOnline.com 250 for the NASCAR Busch Series at noon tomorrow live on ESPN. Our happy hour coverage can be seen at 6 o'clock and RPM tonight at 7 o'clock tomorrow night on ESPN2. Then on Sunday, RPM Today begins our coverage at 11:30. NASCAR Today with Bill Weber at 12:30. The Pepsi 400 at 1 o'clock Eastern Time on ESPN. And then RPM Tonight wraps up the day at 7:30 Sunday night. Again, we'll start qualifying at about 12 minutes from right now. And we'll take a break and be back with more in a moment. ESPN's coverage of Bud Pohl qualifying for Sunday's Pepsi 400 at Michigan being brought to you by Daytona USA, the official attraction of NASCAR, and by NASCAR Online Store, where you'll find a great selection of official gear from all your favorite drivers. Awaiting the start of Bud Pohl qualifying here at quarter of the hour, we go back down to Jerry Punch, who's with our points leader.
And Bobby Labonte had now a comfortable, what seems to be comfortable, with a season-high 101-point lead over Dale Jarrett. Is it ever comfortable, even with 14 races to go?
I don't think it. No, it's never comfortable. Really, it isn't. We've had some good runs here, and we extended it some, but it could definitely go away in a hurry. So we want to make sure we're staying on our toes and just keep on track on top of things and stay on track.
Big smile this week because of what happened at Watkins Glen. A top five finish for you guys.
Yeah, I mean, we had two top fives on the road courses this year, and that was great for us. Last year, we didn't do that. For sure, and the year before that, we were a lot better, so it's kind of been a on-again, off-again deal, but we tested at Sears Point. Tony tested at Watkins Glen. We took, both races and made something out of it, which was really good.
Can't let you go till we ask about brother Terry. I hear the news is getting better day by day for him.
Well, I believe it is, and yesterday I talked to him. He did some running on a go-kart track, and I don't think he'd be mad if I said that, but to try to get the G-forces going and get his inner ear going better, and that's what he's trying to work on to improve that position. And it's a deal where he loses focus when the G-forces and goes against his eardrum and the hairs in your ear, the inner ear, and you got to work it out. And to work it out, he's got to exercise it, and that's what he's been doing. So a little bit of stuff here and there, and he did a little testing at Bristol Monday, realized he needed to go to the doctor again. They did some more stuff, and He actually drove my car at Lakeland on Wednesday. We were down there testing, and he drove it some, and that was a little bit more. So he's been doing some more as it goes, so he's supposed to be here this afternoon.
Tell people what he did the last couple of days at an amusement park to try to get ready. This diagnosis, by the way, is positional vertigo. I heard he was out riding some roller coasters trying to get some G-force working.
At the time, that I haven't talked to him since he started riding them, but I don't know how many he's done since then, but I think he's done a few. So, but yeah, that is one way I guess you could help that out, because if you get dizzy, the cure is to get back on it and go again and try to get it better, or train your ear that way, your vertigo that way, instead of when you get dizzy, you just quit. So he has been riding some roller coasters, I heard, and I talked to Gary DeHart a while ago, and he had talked to somebody else, and they said he was probably going to come up here later on this afternoon. He was still doing some stuff, just trying to train your inner ear and your vertigo to get back into normal mode like it was before the accident. So he has been doing that and some go-kart riding, and drove my car at Lakeland, like I said. So trying to get it where it is better, and to do that, you have to keep working it and make yourself make those G-forces that load on your ear more and more.
Hey, good luck to you in qualifying, and great news about Terry.
Okay, thanks a lot.
A word is possibly that Terry Labonte could be here as early as tomorrow morning, and Gary DeHart said in a Kellogg's driving uniform. If I know Terry Labonte, and if he can get in the car, he will. Bob?
What a great way to rehab, though, on a roller coaster, huh?
No thanks, yeah. Wow.
Hey, when we do go qualifying here in a few moments, we're probably going to see a new track record set. The previous track record is held by the man we just spoke with, Bobby Labonte, at 189.883, but eight were above that, Benny, in practice.
Yeah, you can see from Kenny Schrader up, all those cars broke the existing track record. And Dale Jarrett, over 191 miles per hour.
And here's 16 through 30 with the winningest active driver here at Michigan, Bill Elliott, in 16th position. And now down through the rest of the drivers, Tony Stewart, who won the race here in June, only 34th fastest. Dale Earnhardt, 37th quickest here. And Robert Presley, another driver who competes very well here at Michigan, is only the 41st fastest during the practice period. So again, we wait the start of Bud Pole qualifying on a beautiful day now. Although we did have some rain earlier today, the sun is out at Michigan and scheduled to be the first out. Meanwhile, let's talk with the defending series champion, who's now second in points, Dale Jarrett.
And first in practice here today, the only guy over 191 miles an hour. You're moving now, aren't you?
Yeah, we're flying around here. The cars have gotten so good, engines. The tires that Goodyear's brought here, and we keep learning more and more about these tires and the cars, and it's really fast. The cars are stuck well, but that was whenever it was cloudy and cool, so we're seeing a lot of sunshine now. It could be a lot of difference.
Yeah, the weather has played havoc with practice today.
It has. Got things off to a late start today. The Busch cars were late, and again, we've been in cloudy conditions for at least three-fourths of practice this afternoon, and now we see this sun. This racetrack is very sensitive to the sun, so it's going to be interesting to see who makes the right decisions and the right changes to go with this sun. And the guys going out later could get some cooler temperatures. So it's going to be interesting to see. I'm not sure we'll see a speed quite as fast as what we saw in practice, but they'll be close.
Bobby Labonte runs very well here, but there's some Jarrett magic in Michigan as well.
Well, we've run well here, but I told Bobby after practice, I looked at, and he was right behind me, and I said, well, if you pick up 7 tenths like you did the first race here from practice to qualifying, then you're going to have a heck of a lap around here. And I want to be on top watching it. But you always know that Bobby Labonte has some left. And he couldn't believe that I went out there and ran that fast a lap, because we joke all the time about saving a little bit for qualifying where we don't slow down and make our guys mad at us. And so hopefully we can both go a little bit quicker. And it's going to be interesting. I think there's a lot of guys that have a shot at this.
Thanks for the time. Best of luck.
Thanks a lot.
Back upstairs.
Dale will be out 35th when we begin qualifying, and we will determine the fastest 25 here today. Then second round will determine 26 through 36 starters. And
they're going to make a special announcement about a sponsorship and something that may surprise a few people tomorrow about lunchtime here at Michigan.
Kevin LePage's qualifying lap was 38.330. Average speed was 187.842. And that is just a little bit better than he practiced. So anytime the driver can pick up, the team feels like that they're at least going in the right direction.
Now here is Hut Strickland in the Hills Brothers Coffee Ford. Hunt had his career best finish here at Michigan Speedway back in June of 1991. He did not race in the spring event here, the June race, I should say, of 2000. He did, however, race here a year ago at this time, starting 13th and finishing 9th.
Interesting, both of these first two cars have run up high on the racetrack, down in 1 and 2. And this corner, see Hutch Strickland once again right in the middle of the racetrack. Comes off the corner. Hutch Strickland was 19th fastest in the practice session at 38.13. That would put him faster than LePage. Let's see what he did.
And not quite.
He slowed down from his practice this morning at 38.500, 187.013 miles per hour.
So Hut Strickland just a little slower than Kevin LePage, as the next scheduled car out is now out in turn number two, and that is Chad Little.
And Chad Little struggled in practice one. He was 38th best, as you see, his best start 14th. He did have a sixth place finish here.
Coming off a very good run at Watkins Glen, finished in 12th position, and that moved him up three positions in the point standings from 22nd to now 19th as he takes the green flag and begins the 2-mile run around Michigan Speedway. Chad has had also some Busch starts here at Michigan, four of them to be exact, and finished second at a Busch race back in 1994.
Chad Little goes in the corner. Now he's lower there than the other two cars, but they're still in the middle of the corner, down in 1 and 2. A little wiggle there on the John Deere Ford Taurus. Chad Little comes off the corner.
Stops the clock, and it's better than Hut Strickland, but not quite as good as Kevin LePage.
At 38.401, 187.495, about what he practiced this morning.
Well, in February next year, 2001, they will have the Bud Shootout at Daytona International Speedway. And right now, here are the drivers who have qualified for that by virtue of their pole positions this year. Rusty Wallace has accumulated 7 poles so far this year, with Jared 3, Rudd 2, and everybody else on the list with 1 Bud pole this year. But a good field of cars assembled already for that event in February of next year. Now moving out onto the racetrack is the number 22 Caterpillar Pontiac, driven by Ward Burton.
And Ward was 9th best, so all of a sudden now we'll get probably a pretty good indication as to what kind of speed we can see, and he was just a few hundredths of a second slower than the track record. But once again, all these cars are right in the gray area going down in the corner. This is what you would consider a racing groove. One very high on the racetrack, but evidently that's what these cars like.
Ward Burton has 2 pole positions here at Michigan. Won the pole in June of 98 and in August of last year. In fact, he started on the pole in this race last year and finished last, leading just the first lap. His last pole, by the way, was then last August here at Michigan. And right now he's on the provisional pole
at 37.998, average speed 189.484 miles per hour. To put the Caterpillar Pontiac number one so far.
Benny and Busch qualifying, they were running that line that they always have, that is diving down into the corner in turn one. Why are these cup cars not doing that?
I don't know, Bob. All the cars have been down there. It's very strange to see them there in qualifying mode. It could be that when the sun came out, these cars are so loose they just can't take them down there. They have to go up there and chase the car up the racetrack so they don't spin out.
Jeff Burton now goes on to the racetrack.
Burton was 15th best in practice this morning.
There you see the one and only Bud pole in his career came here at Michigan in August of 1996. His best finish here in a race was in June of last year, 1999. He finished in third position. He led a lap here in June of this year, starting seventh and finishing in 11th position. Jeff Burton currently is fourth in the NASCAR Winston Cup point standings, exactly where he was at this time last year. Here's the checkered flag.
And let's see, does he knock his brother off the pole? No, he's on the outside of his brother at 38.290. Average speed, 188.039. Good enough for second so far.
So Ward Burton right now is the fastest of the first five qualifiers. It's in kart. He's currently second in qualifying here this afternoon.
His best lap was 38.020 seconds. Average speed, 189.374.
Now here is Dale Earnhardt Jr., who was fifth quickest during the practice. So watch this guy. He was about 190 miles an hour. By the way, there are three Earnhardts here this weekend. Carey will attempt to qualify the 71 car. And if all three of them started, it will be the first time that we've had a father and two sons in a NASCAR Winston Cup race in the modern era.
Stumbling, look at that front bumper just right down on the racetrack, all the way across. Car just looks really, really good around the racetrack.
And it's fast. Whoa, look at this.
Oh, my goodness gracious. Woo. Wow, 37.667, 191.149. He broke the track record by a quarter of a second. Whoa.
Wow, great run for Dale Earnhardt Jr. Down to Bill.
I tried to get you on before they knocked you off the pole, but still had a good lap.
It was okay. Track temp has gone up a lot, and we were changing an awful lot of stuff on the Caterpillar Pontiac. We just too daggone loose right there. We had to make the track real big because I was trying to keep it back in under me, but I think that'll get us in the top 10. That'll be a good starting spot for Sunday.
Good luck.
Okay, thanks.
So that's why he ran the high group, and he had to chase the car up there.
Yeah, that's what it looks like. The cars are just very loose, Bill, and they've got to chase them up the racetrack. And it is making the racetrack awfully long, but so did Dale Earnhardt Jr. run up there.
Elliott Sadler and the Wood Brothers for Citgo Ford. Next on to the racetrack for qualifying. Jerry is with Johnny Benson, who passed on his qualifying slot.
Well, the driver of the Aaron Rentz Pontiac was scheduled to go third, JB, and I guess they had a little bit of a problem with the car, but you still have been awfully, awfully quick today in practice.
Yeah, I'm gonna tell you, just a fuel pump problem. We're getting it fixed. They had we almost lost a little bit of practice there and just got out and made a run. We're like third quick. So hopefully we can just go back out and back it up and be in the top 10. We'll be pretty happy with that. But Aaron Rentz Pontiac's running good and all the guys are doing a good job. We're just not a lot of time between practice and trying to get up here going out. I think we went out six, supposed to, and they'll be here. I keep looking. Hopefully it'll be up here shortly.
I hear the front row is a very good possibility. Your guys are pumped about the possibility of starting either first or second here.
Yeah, I mean, I you got a shot, but I, you know, it's like every week. If you got a shot there, you could go either way, five spots. So we're just going to do the best we can and see where it falls.
Hey, good luck to you.
All right, thank you.
Go Weber.
Well, off the win by his teammate last week at the Glen, an outstanding qualifying run for you. Tell me about your lap.
The car was real comfortable. We found something in late in practice that really hooked the car up. We just went through a bunch of shocks and made some decisions and things. And it's good. That's a good lap. Wherever that puts us, I'm happy for the team. We've got a couple new members, and that's a good way to introduce them to our team is to have a good qualifying run today here in Michigan.
And Michigan's been a good track to you.
Yeah, it has. We didn't run well here last year in the Cup race or earlier this year, but we expect to turn that around maybe this weekend. I'm just happy we're getting back up front in our qualifying and hopefully back up front in the races where we need to be.
All right, we'll see if that stands up. Great lap.
Thanks a lot.
Bill Elliott, the six-time Bud Pole winner and seven-time race winner here at Michigan, is on the track. He has the best average starting average of 8.3. And as far as 2000 is concerned, he's been the most consistent qualifier also with 14 top 10 starts. Here's the checkered.
You see it, Earnhardt Jr. We see Bill Elliott goes back to the fourth position at 38.119. Average speed, 188.882. Currently fourth.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. is on the provisional pole. Speedway. Bud Pohl qualifying for Sunday's Pepsi 400. Jimmy Spencer clocked in 13th at 38.450, a 187.256. But Benny, what's up with this smoke that we saw in turn one?
Look on top of his fender, his right front fender. See that bright, that dark spot on top of that fender? Well, here's what happened. Down in the corner, he goes in the corner, and the car goes down. So far, the wheel goes up and rubs the fender, the top of the fender. That's the smoke we see, and it burned the paint off the fender.
Okay, well, up next will be Bobby Hamilton, whose first Bud Pohl in his NASCAR Winston Cup career came here in June of 1996.
Checker flag waves for Hamilton. He was 30th best in practice. How did he do? He is 15th, 38.506, average speed 186.984 miles per hour.
Here's Jerry with Jeff.
And Jeff Gordon is a former winner here, won this race 2 years ago, and a two-time pole sitter. Jeff, how about your shot today?
Well, the car feels good. It's unbelievable just how fast the Winston Cup cars are going around here. Even the Busch cars, I mean, they're fast too. But, you know, Goodyear's got a tire that's just stuck like glue. The aerodynamics of these cars these days are really fast. So I tell you, those are some pretty strong laps they're putting out there. And I ran about as hard as I could. I thought maybe I could run a tenth or two better than that. But that still doesn't put me to where Junior is. So we'd like to get in the 37-second bracket. That'd be really good for the DuPont Chevrolet.
Hey, good luck to you.
All right, thanks.
Jeff Gordon getting ready to qualify. How about Bill Weber with last week's winner?
That'd be Steve Parkin. Right now you're more concerned with the clouds than anything else, aren't you?
Yeah, I'll tell you, that cloud cover just came over, and we've been seeing that all morning with the rain we had here yesterday and this morning and stuff, that Michigan's pretty temperamental to weather. So these guys are going to pick up if that sun stays behind that cloud. And we ran about as fast as we did in practice, and we were like somewhere near the top 10. So we're just hoping that's a good enough run to get us in the top 25 and concentrate on the race. We got a good race car. We're pretty happy with it. We're hoping to go maybe just a little bit faster, but we'll see what this weather does.
Okay, we'll see you Sunday.
Sounds good, Bill. Thank you.
He's going for two in a row. Back to Jerry.
And speaking of good runs last week, how about 42nd to 4th with Robbie Gordon, his career-tying best finish. Robbie, how about how's this team got to be sky high to that run last week?
Yeah, we are. We pushed a little bit in practice, brought a new car here. I think we got maybe a little bit too much rear downforce, but I think we'll have a great race car. The key's going to be getting in the show for us.
Hey, good luck to you in qualifying.
Thank you.
Robbie Gordon waiting to go out. How about Rick Mass, guys? This is a pretty good team. It's really coming together.
Wow, good run for Rick.
Moves into second spot in the 37 bracket at 915. 37.915. His average speed, 189.898 miles per hour. New track record. He also broke the track record. I should say it's new track record, except Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s taking care of that a long time ago.
Exactly. Sterling Marlin will be next. He ended up in 10th position here in the race a couple of months ago in June. And as far as what he practiced at, well, he was 18th fastest during today's practice at 188.981. Everybody's shooting for Dale Earnhardt Jr., who has put up a huge number at 191.149.
What's the front bumper on the 40 car, the Tours car? Let's see what it looks like in the corners. Looks like most of them are pretty well planted to the earth. Yeah, it looks like a snow plow as well. Just no hair at all. I'd hate to have my finger underneath that thing, because I'm sure it would get mashed.
Run complete for Sterling Marlin. It is eighth fastest, 38.263, speed 188.171. 19 have clocked in so far for the Pepsi 400.
It's here, waiting for you.
38.249, a 188.240. Kyle Petty has been bumped. The next onto the racetrack will be Johnny Benson, and on the bubble is Robbie Gordon.
Johnny Benson, as you said, had a fuel pump problem this morning, so he was excused his sixth place qualifying order, but as soon as his car was repaired, they jumped in line and pushed him through, and here he is. And there's a cloud across the racetrack right now. That could help Benson. He had a great run. He was third best in the practice.
And what? What did he? He's going to go down to 13.
Oh, man. All right. Time for Benson, 38.282 seconds. Average speed, 188.078. We talked about three Earnharts. We've seen two. Jerry Punch, let's meet that third.
Well, Benny, Big E right now is 20th. Little E's on the pole. And how about Middle E? We're talking about Kerry Earnhardt, not the middle, actually the oldest son, 30-year-old Kerry Earnhardt. Kerry, you look very, very relaxed. Typical Earnhardt demeanor here, not worried about a thing.
Yeah, you know, like I talked earlier, it's all the press and everything, pressure and all I put on myself is the only pressure I have. And just trying to keep at as low as minimum and just be calm and just, you know, act like it's a normal ARCA deal. It's something I'm used to. It's nothing new. And just treat it like an ARCA deal and just go out there and have fun.
Let's go out and get you one lap in. You were 25th in practice. You're about the middle of the field in practice in a car that you guys have brought along with Dave Marcus. Pretty exciting time for both you and for Dave Marcus coming here as a car owner for the first time.
Yeah, it's a great opportunity. You know, Bill Jordan and Dave Marcus both giving me this opportunity to run the first Winston Cup race. And Dave's been in the, you know, garage with us, helping us on the car, and just helping me on the track, some things he sees. But yeah, it's been a big, great opportunity, and I'd just like to thank both of them and, you know, Team Realtree all together for giving us this opportunity.
Go out there and get you a nice, comfortable lap and get it in the field.
Thank you, Jim.
All right, Kerry Earnhardt, the oldest of the three Earnharts, or the oldest son of Dale Earnhardt, I should say. Let's check in up with Bill Weber, standing by with Jerry Nadeau.
And Jerry Nadeau is here with his crew chief, Tony Furr, talking it over after his qualifying run. How was it?
It wasn't too bad. We had full sun, so we should be pretty proud with that position. You know, this track is so tentative. You know, when the sun comes out, your speeds go down quite a bit. And just like now, the clouds came out, and Ricky Rudd laid down a good lap. So we're pretty pleased. The MichaelHolligan.com car is running good. It's been running good ever since off the trailer. So we're looking for a good start on Sunday, and maybe we'll get our first win.
Yeah, Rudd bumped you back a spot.
No big deal, right?
See you Sunday.
Okay, thanks.
Ricky Rudd, as I said, pushed him back. The Haviland Texaco number 28 has qualified third. His time, 37.941. Average speed, 189.768. So Kyle Petty has been bumped. Robbie Gordon has been bumped. Ted Musgrave, the 01 car, has been bumped. And Brett Bodine, the 11 car, is now the car on the bubble.
And here's the guy that will attempt to bump his way into the top 25. It is Milwaukee, Oregon's Mike Bliss, whose only NASCAR Winston Cup start came here at Michigan in June. He started 27th and finished 37th. However, he did run in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series here at Michigan back in July of 99, starting 7th.
Talked to Barry Dodson last week at Watkins Glen for a little bit, and he expects that once the circuit goes back to these race tracks the second time, this is the second time that Bliss will be here at Michigan, he feels like he will be better. And we see this time he did 23rd so far at 38.467. average speed, 187.173. Brad Bodine has been bumped. Bobby Hamilton on the bump. Be right back.
Up next here on ESPN2, the X Games 2K Kickoff Bash. With the X Games, of course, beginning tomorrow on ABC and coverage this coming week. The X Games from San Francisco. Ricky Craven just did very well in his run.
Yes, he ran the ninth best time at 38.048 seconds. Average speed, 189.235 miles per hour. That pump bumps Dale Earnhardt from the top 25, puts Matt Kenseth now on the bubble. Let's go to the outside of the front row with Bill Weber.
Thank you, Benny. And Dale went exactly as you had predicted. You had a perfect lap in practice. The sun came out, it got a little hotter, slowed down just a tick.
Yeah, it did. I could tell when I went into three the first time that the car just wasn't sticking good. Probably a combination. The set of tires that we had in practice was absolutely perfect. And then it's gotten a good bit hotter. The sun's been out. So that's what makes Junior's lap that much better, to know that he did it out here in the sun. But, we got a little bit loose down in one and two, and just tried to make a decent lap. And we got a good starting spot, and that'll be good enough for us.
See you Sunday.
Okay, thanks.
On the racetrack is the 71 Realtree Chevy, driven by Kerry Earnhardt, who has been running mostly in the ARCA series this year, has five starts, did win an ARCA race at Pocono. Here's his attempt to start his NASCAR Winston Cup career. How'd he do? Is it going to be in the top 25? No.
Goes down to the 31st best at 38.513, average speed, 186.950. and he slowed down about a third of a second from his practice run this morning. Let's go down to jury time.
And one of the drivers will be doing double duty this weekend is Todd Bodine. He starts 16th in tomorrow's Busch Series event at noon on ESPN, and he is in the Kellogg Chevrolet subbing for Terry Labonte. And Todd, how's this Kellogg Chevy? Hey, what do you expect to run?
Well, we don't really know. We had a decent lap in practice, but I got really loose. But we tightened the car up. We got some stickers on here, some Goodyears, and we'll see what we got. If I don't mess up and get a good smooth lap, I think we can be all right.
I know you're subbing for Terry and excited, but the news is awfully good about Terry that he may even be here tomorrow. I know the team's all excited about that because the fact that what you have done for him, as well as the fact that they've been very worried about their driver.
Yeah, it's the news is real good about Terry's condition. He's getting better every day, improving every day. I wouldn't be a bit surprised if he ran Bristol. I hope so. He's awful good at Bristol. They've won there and always run good there. And yeah, the crew is excited about having him. He's supposed to be on his way right now, so it'll be great to have him around tomorrow and have him around for the race.
Good luck in qualifying.
Thanks, Terry.
Todd Bodine subbing for Terry Labonte, who should be on his way to Michigan. Bob?
Just about to complete his run is John Andretti in the Cheerios Pontiac. Matt Kenseth down there in 25th position, as you can see, is on the bubble. Did John bump his way into the lineup? No, he did not.
No, he did not. He's 29th best at 38.475 average speed, 187.135 miles per hour.
John's best finish of the year 2000 so far came here at Michigan in June. On the racetrack is Darrell Waltrip, who has won twice here at Michigan Speedway in 1977 and 84 and won the pole here in June of 81. Darrell is among the drivers who are out of provisional, so he must get into the starting lineup by way of his qualifying speed. There's the best and the slowest as far as the top 25. Range from 191.149 to 187.427. And here is Darrell Waltrip in front of a large crowd and a huge applause taking the green flag.
Darrell took her down in the corner. Boys, he probably took a breath about right here. He's been holding his breath all the way through that corner trying to get the car back under control. Once again, another corner coming up. Got home with breath again. Turn that wheel down. There you go. Get those hands working in there. He's off the corner. Did he do it, Bob? Did not run exceptionally good lap in practice. What's this qualifying lap?
And is it in the top 25? No.
No. 35th best. 38.623, 186. 0.417. Somewhere, somehow, Darrell, you got to pick up about a third of a second between now and tomorrow's qualifying. Just one third of a second. Not much. Hard to find on the racetrack.
Sure is. All right, next out. Car looks a little different this week. Tony the Tiger being saluted by the Kellogg's people. And, of course, Kellogg's make those great breakfast cereals not too far from here. So Todd Bodine, who has not raced in Winston Cup here at Michigan since June of 1996, will qualify the number five car vacated temporarily by Terry Labonte.
Todd was 27th best in the practice runs held here earlier before qualifying. Matt Kent, oh, he's very, very high down in the corner. Looks like he really had to chase that car up the racetrack. Would be shocked if this is a great qualifying run.
Todd ran Indianapolis in this car and then ran another car at Watkins Glen last weekend, where he finished in 42nd position. Here he comes to the checkered flag, and Todd Bodine becomes our 39th qualifier of the afternoon. And he's going to make it.
Right. 23rd best. 38.354, 187.725. Much better lap than I thought it would be. Attaboy, Todd.
Robert Presley always runs well here at Michigan Speedway. We'll see how he qualifies when we come back in just a moment.
Didn't quite calculate enough for that, but really good job. The guys did a great job on the car. Same one we had here in the spring, and run about the same speed, so I guess that's what it's got.
Good luck to you on Sunday.
Yeah, thanks.
I'll be Bonnie fifth right now. How about Rusty Wallace? 7 poles this year, guys. Bob, could he make it 8?
Well, we're going to know here in a few minutes. This is the 13th time in the year 2000 that we have seen a new track record set at a Winston Cup track. It right now is held by Dale Earnhardt Jr. at 191.149. But let's see what Rusty can do here in the late afternoon, although the sun's still beaming down on both sections of the racetrack. Got a cloud there in turn number 4. Here's the checkered flag.
Looked awfully good, but the sun might have been too much for Rusty to overcome, was it?
Yeah, it's down at the 9th.
9th spot. 37.999. Average speed 189.479 miles per hour. The 21 car, Elliott Sadler's been bumped. Todd Bodine has been bumped. Right now, Kevin LePage is the car on the bubble.
And the last qualifier here this afternoon will be Mark Martin, who started on the pole here in 1990 in the June race and has won here 4 times. In practice today, he was second quick with a lap at 190.582. So he's going to have to find more than that here in qualifying to knock Dale Earnhardt Jr. off the pole.
And as you said, Bob, there is some shade up in turn 4 and down the front straightaway, but that turns 1 and 2. There's a cloud following Mark Martin down in the corner. Will he get to 1 before he does? No, he drives off into the sunshine.
Put together.
Ooh, that's the lowest car we've seen on the racetrack.
We've been wondering where that line is all afternoon.
Yeah, that's one we've been waiting for right there.
Had a great run last weekend at Watkins Glen, breaking that streak of 2 consecutive last place finishes. He started 10th and finished runner-up to Steve Park. Mark Martin through turns 3 and 4, up high, coming off turn number 4. Here it is. We'll see if Dale Earnhardt Jr. has his second career pole, and if Mark can knock him off. The report is that he did not. 7th quick.
7th best. 37.971. Average speed 189.618 miles per hour. Kevin LePage is now down to 26th. The 25th qualifier is Joe Nemechek.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. wins his second career pole position in Winston Cup competition. He also won the pole at Charlotte earlier this year at Lowe's Motor Speedway. Here's the rundown. Dale Jarrett will start on the outside of row number 1, and a great run for Rick Mast, who starts in 3rd position on Sunday. Here's the rest down through number 25. Nemechek, the 25th fastest qualifier. Everybody else, as we indicated, will have to decide whether to stay on the time or to participate in second round qualifying here at Michigan tomorrow morning.
And CDW back in 43rd, got to pick up some speed, and there's some more cars that really need to find some speed between now and tomorrow. Let's go to Bill Weber.
Well, it's Dale and Dale on the front row, but it's the Bud Chevy that wins the Bud pole. Congratulations.
Man, thanks a lot, Bill. We really needed something like this to happen. You know, we've had so much terrible luck, and we put ourselves in some bad positions. Last week we tore up 2 race cars at Watkins Glen. First time I ever done that, and I went home, I tell you, with my tail between my legs, and beat myself up pretty bad. But we came back strong and been working hard together today just to get this car fast, and it's shown. I mean, we really qualified well, and everybody's working together well. I mean, there's other things going on just aside from just going out there and making the lap that's making me feel good and showing some improvement in his team.
Congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. leads him to the green flag, Bob.
And what should be a very good race will happen here tomorrow at noon Eastern time. It'll be on ESPN, the NapaOnline.com 250 for the NASCAR Busch Series. Don't forget Happy Hour and RPM tonight, also tomorrow. Sunday, you can begin your day with RPM today at 11:30, NASCAR today at 12:30, and then the Pepsi 400 at 1 o'clock on Sunday afternoon on ESPN, and then RPM tonight at 7:30 on Sunday night. Congratulations to Dale Earnhardt Jr., who wins the Bud Poll for Sunday's running of the Pepsi 400 here at Michigan Speedway. Coming up next, the X Games 2K kickoff bash. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you tomorrow at noon Eastern time for the Busch Race here at Michigan. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com.